Here is the Burgess apartment on the third floor of 44 Avenue Pasteur. Two flats knocked into one, I understand. So from here, when he went to fulfill an unpleasant duty in RT, he will have walked from his apartment, short walk along here to the station, which is there behind the church. Welcome to In Search of Anthony Burgess. I'm in a place called Antibes. This is where Anthony Burgess came to conduct what I term the interview of ingratitude. La résidence des fleurs. Notice that this writer gets some kind of pluck. I just travelled by train to this town and climbed up from the station to this flat. Burgess writes in You've Had Your Time.
I went to Antibes to interview Graham Greene for the Observer.
The Observer is a London newspaper.
I limped up the hill to Monte Carlo Station, caught the stopping train, cacti, airs of Beaulieu-sur-Mer, Nice, Saint-Laurent-du-Var, Côte de Cagne, Cagne-sur-Mer, Villeneuve-Loubet, Bio. Green's apartment was only 100 yards up the hill from Antibes station, but I had to take a taxi. Green, in his middle 70s, living with a chic French bourgeoise whose leg was not broken, was fitter than I at 63. We talked, and I bought him lunch. He seemed pleased at what he termed my
suffering venerability.
And when I sent him the typescript of our colloquy, accepted that this was a true account. I did not, of course, use a tape recorder. Later, he contributed to the sayings of the week in the Observer the following remark.
Burgess put words in my mouth which I had to look up in a dictionary.
This turned me against him. I had elected the Joycean way in the sense of a deliberate use of hard words to check the easy passage of the reader in the manner of potholes in the road and occasional ambiguous, while Green had made the popular novel of adventure his model.
Côté rue.
Vous voyez côté chat, il se passe.
Ça, c'est
conceited ass.
I've said in an earlier video that W. Somerset Maugham was doomed to be popular. Well, Graham Greene was doomed both to be a popular novelist and to have had his head permanently up the arse of the British establishment.